Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with again the discrete time random processes, our third chapter from the subject advanced digital signal processing. As of from the previous three videos, we have been a practice of various problems associated to the special types and in general the random processes. Here the first problem we have seen for the random process, the corresponding power spectrum for the given random processes we have determined there. Into the second one, we had to validate whether the given matrix was a valid autocorrelation matrix or not. Into the previous video, we have dealt with the special type of random process to be the autoregressive process, that was abbreviated as AR in the bracket P here. Now in continuation to the same, where we have determined the unit sample response of the filter for determination or derivation of that random process, the autocorrelation sequence of the output random process, the power spectrum of the random process. Here we are again going to have determination of the same three values for the three parts for, but now this time for the moving average random process, the another special type here. So let us title this particular problem to be the problem number 4 for random process. So let us see what is the problem statement and how we can determine the answers to the given task here. So let us begin with the topic. So now we can start with our topic titled problem 4, a random process. So here we are provided with the problem statement, and this problem statement starts with, consider an MA in bracket Q process that is generated by the difference equation which is given to us. Y of n is equal to the summation k is equal to 0 to q over b of k in multiplication to w of n minus k, where w of n is a zero mean white noise with the variance represented sigma suffix w square. So this is what the given details for the moving average, that is MA in the abbreviation here. Now what is asked to us? We have been asked to find the solution for three parts. The first part is part A. Find the unit sample response of the filter that generates Y of n from W of n. In the part B, we have to find the autocorrelation of Y of n. In the part C, we have to find the power spectrum of Y of n. This problem is very much similar to the previous one, problem number 3. Random process. So thereupon it was the special case of autoregressive. Now here we have the special case of moving average random process here. Now getting back to the given details of the problem statement, for the moving average MA in bracket Q where P is equal to 0. In the previous case AR in the bracket P, Q was equal to 0, both were derived from the another special type of the random process called as autoregressive moving average random process, abbreviated as ARMA in the bracket P, Q here. So for the same topic that we delivered to be the 19th topic there it was the filter function represented to derive the same random process by H of Z here. So that particular H of Z filter function we can recall from the same video and make the changes to substitute P equal to 0 to determine the moving average random process. By substituting Q equal to 0, we determine AR, that is autoregressive random process. So here we have the case of moving average random process. So it is denoted by Y of n and it is derived by the use of W of n. So here we have W of n minus 1 in multiplication to B of k, the filter coefficients we can say, which is operated by the summation k is equal to 0 to q. So the total number of zeros to this transfer function representing the filter. So this W of n, which is helpful to have the derivation of the intended random process Y of n, is a white noise random process that we are covered in the 15th topic here. Now here we have the mean for the same. Mean is the ensemble average, the important one. it is also known by the expected value. So that value is equal to 0. So it is generally represented m sub x for the random process x of n, as we have y of n here, and here we are talking about w of n. M sub w is equal to 0, hence it is called as 0 min, and further white noise random process, and the variance is represented another m symbol average to be sigma sub w square here. So one by one we shall go for the solution of part A, the unit sample response of the filter for generation of y of n. Then next to that, finding the autocorrelation of y of n, and lastly finding the power spectrum of y of n here. So let us start with the part A. So as we have to go for the filter function of y of n, so y of n as shown in the given equation, that it is generated by filtering the white noise represented w of n. So here we have the FIR filter that has the system function by this expression here. So this is the system function into the z domain, hence represented capital H of z. Into the frequency domain, we have the denotion of the signals by the capital letters, whereas into the time domain, whether it is continuous time or the discrete time domain, we use the small casing of the letters to represent here. So H of z, here it is the summation k is equal to 0 to q, it should be to the power, it should be q here, the number of zeros, over b of k multiplied to z of minus k here. So this is the representation of the same filter into the z domain. If we take the inverse transformation, we can get back to the time domain, and that too a discrete time domain. Z transformation is especially with the discrete time domain. So the required answer can be like this. The required answer is nothing but the unit sample response of the filter that generally we denote by h of n, and here we compute it by k is equal to 0 to q, the summation carried over b of k multiplied to the tail of n minus k here. So this is what the answer for part A we have, that we can outline here. Now in the part B, we are asked to have determination of the autocorrelation sequence for the output random process denoted y of n here. So as autocorrelation sequence can be denoted r suffix, the mention of random process. So r suffix y we have to denote. So r suffix y of k will be the autocorrelation sequence for the y of n, and that can be computed by having here it the sigma letter, a typing mistake here. So this is nothing but the variance sigma suffix w square here as a function of, and in multiplication to del of k it should be. So this is further convolved with the h of k, further convolved to h of minus k. So this is the same procedure we have opted into the previous problem also, and this leads to the next step, the more convenient here, that we have sigma suffix w square, the variance of the white noise random process that is useful to have generation of y of n, which is having in multiplication to the summation where l is equal to 0 to q minus mod k over the multiplication of b of l to b of mod k plus l here. So this becomes the answer for the autocorrelation sequence or the output random process y of n. Now switching to the part C, where we have been asked to find the power spectrum of y of n. So as we have here derived the autocorrelation sequence, it is quite easier to have determination of the power spectrum by taking a Fourier transformation. So here for part C, we obtain the power spectrum or power spectral density by the Fourier tool represented capital P suffix y as a function of e to the power g omega, computed by sigma suffix w square, the variance, in multiplication to capital B as a function of e to the power g omega, in multiplication to capital B as a function of e to the power minus j omega it should be. So the details of what exactly the B, the filter coefficients that we can take from the previous video where we have learned the moving average random processes. So this completes the answer for part C and also finishes the problem number 4 for the random process. By the next lecture, we shall continue into the same chapter, discrete time random processes, to have the practice of the next problem titled problem 5, random process. Thank you.